Hello viewers, today we are going to know about black holes. A black hole is a region of space-time where gravity is so strong that nothing, no particles or even electromagnetic radiations such as light cannot escape from it. Let's know about the history of the black hole. The idea of a black hole was proposed by English astronomical pioneer John Michell in a letter published in November 1784. Michell referred to these bodies as dark stars, and such supermassive but non-radiating bodies might be detectable through gravitational effects on nearby visible bodies. In 1915, Albert Einstein developed the theory of general relativity, having earlier shown that gravity does influence light's motion. As per Einstein, gravity is caused when some mass causes bend in space-time. More mass means more gravity. But the black hole is defined as a puncture in space-time that is very much deep, that gravity becomes very high and even light cannot escape from it. How a black hole is formed? First, let's know about how a star is formed. Star formation. It is a process by which dense regions within the molecular clouds in interstellar space, sometimes called star-forming regions, collapse and form stars. These clouds are formed of mostly hydrogen, about 24% of helium and very small amounts of other gases. These giant clouds have very much mass, and due to the immense pressure and gravitation, the hydrogen molecules collide at very high speed, and nuclear fusion happens and very much energy is released. This is how a star works, and for billions of years the star keeps shining. What happens when a star runs out of fuel? To know about this, let's first know about supernova. A star is a giant mass of gas with a core. The gravitational force keeps pulling the matter of a star into a core, and in a normal shining star, the nuclear fusion keeps emitting nuclear energy to balance this gravitational energy. After the fuel or the hydrogen atoms end in a star, the star turns into a blue color element, then red giant, and eventually releases all the elements collected in it in the process of nuclear fusion by explosion except the core. And all the elements are dispersed in this process by explosion into the universe. This process is called supernova. Then slowly, the star's core contracts so much that the density of the star becomes very high and leads to a situation where the escape velocity increases so much that even light cannot escape from it. The escape velocity is described by this equation. Here, VE becomes even more than the c, which is the speed of light, and becomes the black hole. Black hole has two parts, event horizon and the hole. Event horizon is the last possible distance anything can move up to and return back. After any object reaches the event horizon, it stretches such that it is converted into energy and is attracted towards the center of the black hole. The reason behind the stretching of an object is that the gravitational force is very high, such that it acts differently on different parts of an object and leads to the stretching of the object. Time for any object to disappear is dependent on the size of the black hole. For black holes of small size, the time is small as the center is at a small distance from the event horizon. For black holes of larger size, the time is even large as the center of the black hole is at larger distance from the event horizon. The time speed becomes very less near a black hole, and it is assumed that there is no existence of time inside the black holes. What are supermassive black holes? Supermassive black hole is found at the center of each galaxy. These supermassive holes have very much mass. That mass is million times of the sun and has attained the mass by merger with other holes and depositing stars and other celestial bodies inside it. What is the supermassive black hole of the galaxy Milky Way? Sagittarius A. It is the supermassive black hole at the center of our galaxy and is 4 million times massive than ours. Its strong gravitational pull draws nearby stars and gas clouds into its accretion disk. What is the most supermassive black hole of the universe? The most supermassive black hole of the universe is TON 618, with a mass of 6.6 into 10 raised to power 10 of the mass of the sun. It is located at a distance of approximate 18.2 billion light years.
It is located near the border of constellations Canes Venetici and Coma Berenices. How do we detect a black hole? There are two things. Black hole's gravitational field tends to make nearby stars and celestial bodies revolve around it. Black holes are the huge punctures in the space-time that generate gravitational fields, which can be detected by detecting gravitational waves.
On 10 April 2019, black hole's first image was captured by NASA. The picture captured was of a supermassive black hole and its shadow. The image reveals the central black hole of Messier 87, a massive galaxy in the Virgo cluster. It is more than 50 million light years away. Its mass is same as 6.5 billion times the Sun. It is a massive black hole and a very large distance away. So to capture it, we needed a telescope nearly the size of the Earth. And so many telescopes around the Earth were to be synchronized to make a larger telescope named Event Horizon. Event Horizon collaboration is powered by 8 ground-based radio telescopes in Chile, Mexico, Spain, Hawaii, Arizona, and the Antarctica. Overseen by the international team of radio astronomers, these telescopes were continuously aiming at the heart of the galaxy from 2017. All the images were collaborated in the supercomputers and released on 10 April 2019. We now know that black holes eat the nearby objects and become greater in magnitude. But how can a black hole end? Let's first know about Hawking's radiation. In 1974, Stephen Hawking proposed the concept of Hawking's radiation. According to him, as sun emits solar radiation, black hole also emits radiation during the process of vaporization of the black hole. Yes. The black hole slowly vaporizes and also swallows objects. As the rate of swallowing is more than the vaporization rate, it does not lead to decrease the size of the black hole. But as per Hawking's, after a limit of mass swallowing, the black hole bursts and all of the energy is released into the universe. But as per now, 10 raised to power 67 years it will take to a black hole to end. What happens when two black holes collide? When two black holes approach each other, they circle around each other and after some time they merge to form black hole of bigger size. What's inside the black hole? Today, if someone tries to go inside a black hole, due to the extreme gravity, it will tear into fractions and ultimately will disappear. So we can only predict and not prove. Some people say that there is another world and there is a way to connect both worlds. And some say that there are the remnants of the dead star. But at this time, we can only predict. In this video, we have covered almost everything about black holes, but knowledge is unlimited, and please write below the extra facts you know about black holes, and also write the suggestions to improve our content. Thank you for watching.